speaking today with Bridget Hanna at the Melbourne Museum's Learning Lab, which is part of Museums Victoria. Her project, River Connections, won a bunch of awards, Best in Show and Multimedia at the Museum's Australasia Multimedia Publication Design Awards, as well as the Good Design Award, Best in Class in Digital Design for Game Design and Animation, and the Creative Communication Awards, Best of the Best in Animations, TV, Film. That is an amazing list of awards. So congratulations, Bridget, and also congratulations on being a Best in Heritage Laureate. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you so much. Before we begin, I'd really like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land in which I work, the people of the Eastern Kulin Nation, and pay my respects to their ancestors past, present, and emerging. The language groups in this area are the Woiwurrung and Bunurong, and how you say welcome in these languages is Wurmanjaka. So Wurmanjaka to our learning lab. I'd also like to take this moment to acknowledge that this land has never been ceded, and the traditional owners of this land maintain knowledge practiced through generations. They are the first and ongoing educators, technologists, storytellers of this land.
Beautiful. Thank you for that. I want to dive into your project. So can you tell us about it? Describe the project, how it came about, and just the experience of it, I think, for people that haven't been there.
Definitely. So River Connections is an immersive projection experience in Melbourne Museum's Learning Lab. River Connections and the Learning Lab followed a parallel development and design process and share interrelated goals. So it's a bit tricky to talk about one without the other. So the projection experience submerges viewers into first people's perspectives of the environment and shares their deep connection to the rivers and the land. The experience was made in collaboration with Museums Victoria, the design company Grumpy Sailor, and First Peoples elders and collaborators Auntie Esther Kirby, Uncle Brendan Kennedy, Uncle Larry Walsh, and consultant curator Genevieve Greaves. Each scene, image, and sound, as well as the overall structure of the piece, was developed through a consultative and collaborative process of deep listening sessions and also visiting elders on country. So as an immersive film, River Connections takes audiences on a journey through the unique environments of the Murray River. The Murray River is the central subject of the film and is one of the main waterways in Victoria and Australia. And it's a controversial site of ecological, cultural, and economic importance. So it is through this vessel that the experience explores ideas of sustainability and interconnectedness. The style of the piece is quite abstract, and the narrative is poetic rather than didactic, which leaves room for viewers to make their own connections to the message. The central theme of the experience is the interconnectedness of all things, a concept that Auntie Esther, Uncle Brendan, Uncle Larry, and Genevieve regularly talked about during our collaboration. This motif is visualized with flowing lines that depict ever-changing subjects morphing from one form to another. The experience is divided into three acts. It begins by sharing how all life is connected and dependent on a healthy environment to thrive. And then the middle act demonstrates how overuse of our waterways and pollution from human activity puts this connection at risk. And then our final moment shares a hope for the future, where we're able to connect, restore our natural ecological systems and live in harmony with the land. So as an immersive projection experience, we refer to River Connections as a 3D animated infinity projection. And we use the phrase infinity projection as the animation creates the illusion of depth and motion. So we take audiences on a journey along, through, above, and below the river throughout the experience. And we show this River Connections experience at the beginning of every workshop in the Learning Lab as an acknowledgement of First Peoples' deep connection to the land on which we've lived, who have lived here in Australia for over 60,000 years.
So, I mean, this just sounds amazing, and the visuals are beautiful. So how did the project come about? Like, what was the origination of this?
Yes, great question. So when we were creating the Learning Lab, we took on a holistic approach to redesigning Melbourne Museum's learning spaces and philosophy to learning. So this included incorporating digital technologies into our learning spaces and placing First Peoples' living cultures, histories, and knowledge at the core of our teaching practice. So we worked really closely with our core audience when developing this space and River Connections, which of course is educators. And we knew that these were two curriculum areas that they wanted support in their teaching. So through multiple sessions with teacher advisory groups and testing sessions with students, as well as a bunch of creative brainstorming with Grumpy Sailor and Museums Victoria staff, we were really able to set a clear goal. So our goal was to create a shared multi-sensory learning experience that would ground all Learning Lab workshops in First Peoples knowledge and connection to the land. So we also wanted to create an experience that encouraged deep listening. And at the beginning of each workshop, we asked participants to practice deep listening as they watch River Connections. So deep listening is a process used by First Peoples around the world that describes deep and respectful listening to build community and connection. And deep listening involves listening with your ears, but also with all of your other senses too. It's about being still and quiet to expand your senses and help you see the interconnectedness in all things. So part of deep listening is also about taking what you've learned on acting on it. And I just wanted to share, while we're talking about the goals of the project and how it came about, the voiceover narration that plays at the beginning and end of River Connections. So this voiceover was delivered by Auntie Esther Kirby, who was one of our collaborators. And she says, "It just flows. I think we knew every bend. Physically, mentally, and emotionally, we're connected to that land. That water and that land is a part of us." And at the end of the piece, she says, "We survived on that river. The river and the water, the ocean, it's everybody's health. So we have a responsibility to our children, our grandchildren, and our great children, great grandchildren, and it's our job to look after that." And I think that really speaks to the goals of what we wanted to get out of this piece. It's all about learning something and acting on it.
So what have you heard from participants in the experience that they most enjoy? What is the experience your visitors are having? What is it you intended? And was any part of this designed to be interpreted by audience members through their own experience of being in the room, of that actual experience?
Yes. So the experience was deliberately abstract in nature because we wanted our audiences to make their own connections to the message and the experience. So I've definitely observed audiences having different reactions watching, especially different ages. Some that we really hoped for and we thought would happen, and others that were quite a surprise. One thing that is a surprise that I've seen watching people experience River Connections is observing how really young children interact with the space. So we wanted kids to be able to move around the space and chase the Murray Cod as it swam around the room. And they definitely do this. However, we never predicted the intensity that they would quite go to in their movements. On the other side, when we have school groups in here, they're much more still and quiet, and they do that deep listening really well. And one of my favorite things is when you're sitting in this room, you get eaten by a Murray Cod as it swims towards you. And we always wanted that moment for young children to kind of gasp when that happened. And we were really able to get that reaction as we've had primary school aged children through the space. And then teens and adults have been really interested in the technology and where the sound is coming from, where the projectors are in the space. And then they're having really meaningful conversations about sustainability and First Peoples knowledge after watching the experience. One thing that I really didn't predict was that audiences really enjoy watching the experience multiple times. So when we created it, it was created to be shown once at the start of a workshop. Now, during COVID times, we haven't been able to do workshops in this space, but we're just about to start up, which is very exciting. But we've opened the space up and visitors can just wander on in from the forecourt of the museum and sit down and watch immersive content that we have in this space. And River Connections is one of those pieces of content. And we had for a little while River Connections on loop, pretty much to encourage audiences to come in and then move through the space and move around the museum so that they weren't lingering for a long time as we had capacity restrictions in this space. We were noticing that families were sitting in here for 45 minutes at a time and watching the experience over and over and over again. And I think that that's a real credit to the beauty of the visuals, but also the beautiful message that really makes you want to sit and listen and look and sit and listen and look again and again as you're watching the experience.
That's, I mean, that must be such a rewarding feeling for you and the team. So can you talk, because when you create something like that and you can see it, that's the beauty of this work, that when we're lucky enough to see people experience it, a thing that we've poured so much into, that's, it's good to remind us what we're doing in museums and like why we're there.
I think so as well. And especially over the last year where, you know, we haven't been able to be on site and inviting audiences in it, into our spaces for such a long time. That was a real struggle for me because we opened at the start of last year, our learning lab space, and then we didn't get audiences through till, you know, a good 6 to 8 months after we opened. We closed as soon as we opened because of COVID outbreaks. So it was a long wait and we were patient, but that final kind of payoff and recognition that you've done a really great thing by seeing those audiences' reactions and observing them interacting in the space has just been one of the best feelings.
Oh, I can imagine. Yeah. That's beautiful. Can you talk a little about how you collaborated with the First Peoples community, what role they played, how did they inform the content or even the execution of the piece? And what was the process for putting the team together, both of external community, but also museum employees?
So when creating this experience, we began by speaking with Museums Victoria's First Peoples Department and began consulting with Genevieve Greaves. And it's from this knowledge sharing that the theme of the Murray River emerged and a First Peoples collaboration group was formed with members from Yulenj. So Yulenj is a Kulin word for knowledge and intelligence. And Museums Victoria has a Yulenj advisory group, which comprises of 16 respected community members and elders from across Victoria. So it was Auntie Esther, Uncle Brendan and Uncle Larry who were part of Yulenj, who each had really strong bonds to rivers and surrounding wetlands, and they generously shared their knowledge and experience with the team to shape the content of River Connections. So we began by running a series of deep listening sessions with Auntie Esther, Uncle Brendan, Uncle Larry and Genevieve to share knowledge and stories, and some broad concepts kept reoccurring during these sessions, especially the notion of interconnectedness. So everything that you see in River Connections is actually based on those deep listening workshops and conversations that we had with the elders from those sessions. And I wanted to share some examples and quotes with you. So yeah. This one is from Uncle Larry. So he says, "It's not just the rivers themselves, it's all the connections. This is the smaller vein that joins another vein that creates the larger vein, which is the river. And that's what we're at risk of losing if we can't put it together." And then we have a moment within the film in which we have a bird's eye view of the Murray River, and it is animated in a way that it looks like veins from a human. So making that really clear link between us and the rivers and how connected we are in that space. And another theme that emerged from these deep listening sessions was empathy and perspective. So specifically this idea that we could see the world and use our senses and connect with people and animals. So there's a quote from Uncle Brendan, which is embedded in the opening shot of the film, where we get a bird's eye view of a cormorant as it's swooping down to land in the Murray River. And Uncle Brendan says, "So I'm thinking, how do we express my feelings around what my pelican is seeing and doing and flying and looking over country? How do we translate that and put that into some sort of visual form, whether it's animation or the colours?" So Grumpy Sailor worked with all of these themes that came out of the deep listening sessions, and they produced an experience that had the three sections representing the past, present and a hopeful future. And then they checked in with the Museum Victoria team and First Peoples collaborators as they were developing the story and refined it constantly based on all of our feedback. Once the three-act structure was approved, we really honed in to look at the look and feel of the experience. And the filmmakers from Grumpy Sailor actually visited Uncle Brendan and Auntie Esther on the Murray River where they live. And they took the opportunity to hear, see, and fully experience the environments that the elders had described in our deep listening sessions. So the trip helped to bring River Connections to life. And it ensured a really visual and oral authenticity to the experience. So this is one of my favorite things about River Connections is every single detail in the experience was based on images, photographs, and sound recordings from that trip up to visit Auntie Esther and Uncle Brendan. So the colors in the experience were all sampled from photographs that were taken during those visits. All the sounds that you hear were recorded next to the Murray River, and together this really gives a great sense of, and a real sense of place in the film, even though the imagery is quite abstract and has that animated feel to it.
I mean, that's amazing. How big was the team to talk a little bit about the different sort of disciplines within, like what were the different roles on the team? Like what were the different sort of disciplines and talent sets?
So we had lots of different people working across different departments at Museums Victoria on this project. So there's a lot of amazing creative people of whom we definitely don't have time to mention today that worked on the development of the Learning Lab and River Connections. So I've actually put together a list of those involved, which I hope you'll share on the screen right now, to acknowledge those who worked in this space. So from content creators like Grumpy Sailor, who we worked with, to museum educators, to Museum Victoria scientists, to technical staff and digital media staff and project managers. It took a lot of passion and creative work from a range of people to create our Learning Lab and River Connections experience.
We've been talking with Bridget Hanna at the Melbourne Museum's Learning Lab, which is part of Museums Victoria. And Bridget, thanks for talking again, and congratulations again for being named a Best in Heritage Laureate. Thanks for being with us today.
Thanks so much for having me, Brad.